Alright guys, so it's been a while, but today is the day I'm finally going to do the full detail paint correction, what I can do. This is the current setup. As you can see now, I have the cartridge, the K1700, I think. I got that from, Costco? Not sure. I got it online. Yeah, Costco. Got my hose. This is a Princess Auto reel. Yeah, and I got my jumper hose from there to there. Or not jumper hose, but a long hose, just in case. I didn't know where I would be putting the power pressure washer. And then only a 2 foot. And I thought I ordered a 4 foot. But whatever the case is, they're all expensive. They're all like $50. So yeah, I'm going to set that up. Go with a quick car wash first. I guess I can finally use a dish soap as a decontamination kind of thing. But I don't really have any sealants on the paint right now anyways. I do have a little issue right here, but I will deal with that later because it broke again. So yeah, I'm not sure. This side is fine. There's a tab on the inside that pretty much got rubbed, broken by the wheel. On this side, for some reason it hits it. I don't know if any of you know why that might be the case, but this little metal, the screw for the bumper tab keeps getting hit by it, and then it gets pulled down, broke the tab. I epoxied it, fixed it, but it broke again. So, after raising it too. So I'm not sure why, but I'm not gonna worry about that right now. I'm just gonna start with the car wash. This car is filthy. Some nice bird poop. I don't know if you can tell. I'm not gonna do the wheels now because I'm gonna coat those as well. And I'm gonna do those with it off the car, so I might do it another time. But we'll see. We'll see how it goes. Done with the wash. I'm probably gonna do iron decon now, and then the clay bar. The back is just in the sun, kind of from the quarter panel in the back. So I mean, that's a little bit of a problem, but I'll move it up actually to dry in a sec. You can see under the car is a lot of purple, so you know it's working. Can't see it on the paint much because it's black, but hopefully you can see under the car. Honestly, it's not much. The paint is in relatively good condition. Yeah, looks like it's did its magic, so I guess I'll rinse it off. Maybe you'll see some purple then. Done with the clay bar. Honestly, the paint was pretty smooth. The front is a little weird. There's a little paint chips that I think catch the clay, so there's little specks, but hopefully they'll go away. I might do a quick once over with the sponge just because, I mean, obviously I used ONR, so I used an ONR clay lube solution, so now that stuff's all over the paint. So pretty much just a final rinse off, and then I can dry it and prepare for the polishing step. So let's do a quick spray and done. All right, time to dry the car. I'm gonna start with, I'll lift this up because it leaks a bunch, and then I will use my leaf blower to dry the rest, and then obviously hand dry it. These things are pretty useful. $20 on Amazon. Canadian. So I'm gonna try to pull it in here. I know it's not much space, but we'll make it work. As long as it got room to work on it, so yeah, I'm definitely good. I'm gonna dry it up now. So it looks like the clay bar actually marred the paint a lot more than I expected it to, but you know, you can actually see a lot of the scratches now, which is fine. It's normal, it's expected. You can't really tell, but there's a lot there. I mean, you can see that right there. I'm not too sure if that is a chip or not. You know what, I don't think it is, so I might have to go farther down and try to get that out. This one, that one's almost gone. There was two specks here, now there's only one left. So I'll get rid of that, and I did a little bit up here. I might refinish that as well. I'm gonna try to get that out now. And this. A few more passes, got it out. Both little pieces are specks of epoxy. And then up here, just making sure that it's smooth. Now, I have a little bit of issues here, but I'm just gonna try to polish over it. Should be okay. I'll start and then I'll give you guys a update. I went around the whole car with the cutting compound, and like, you know, between an orange and yellow, as well as a microfiber disc, because I've had some harder to get scratches. So I started on the polish, started from the driver's side, and I'm all the way around here, working on the passenger fender now. I don't know if you can tell, but if you look in the reflection, pretty good. I'm just gotta do this portion here now. I just did that. Using 210, so I was using Meguiar's 110 and 210. I don't know if I didn't really share that, but yeah, the 110, holy crap, it gives a lot of dust, at least for me. Like, I'm not really sure, they say it's not, there's no dust, but there's a lot. All right, 25. Torquex, the Chemical Guys Torquex package on Amazon came with these three of these towels, and they've been working pretty well. I do need something else for the actual ceramic coating though. I don't know if I have any good towels to wipe it off. You want to make sure that after, or when you're wiping it, you're not scratching the paint again. So usually do it in the light. I've already kind of been watching, and I've noticed these are good, so I haven't been getting any scratches after wiping. Alright, so fender done. Time to do hood, front bumper, and side mirrors and roof. That's next. So we're done polishing, finally. A lot of work, but, you know, this is what you're... That actually doesn't look good, what the hell? Okay, in the camera... In the camera, it looks like it's refracting, but in real life, it is reflecting perfectly. So, please take my word for it. This was a lot of work, as you can see. Boom. Yeah, it's weird that the light reflects, but you can see the roof ceiling pretty well. Yeah, hard to tell. But anyways, I gotta figure out some kind of panel wipe situation. And then get on the coating. Can't wait to pull it out in the sun. Obviously not today. Oh my god. Alright, I got a little carried away, so I didn't really record any of it, but I've already applied and wiped off the ceramic coating. It's been 12 hours, so it should be cured. I did have to redo a couple things because I didn't wipe it off properly, so you get little watermarks. So I polished it out, and then I reapplied it just in case. Yeah, overall looks pretty good. It was my first time, so I gotta admit, did have some complications along the way. A little marring from the microfibers, but for the most part, I'm pretty happy with the job, so. It is what it is. Boom. Like, I don't know. Looks pretty good, right? What is going on in my hair?